गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, एज पर आर लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव ऑलरेडी गॉन थ्रू विद चैप्टर नंबर 1. टुडे वी आर स्टार्टिंग चैप्टर नंबर 2, अ वेरी स्मॉल पार्ट ऑफ इट. दैट इज चैप्टर नंबर 2 इज सेंट्रल प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ एन इकोनॉमी. नाउ वट डू मीन बाई इकोनॉमिक प्रॉब्लम? नाउ इकोनॉमिक प्रॉब्लम इज द प्रॉब्लम ऑफ चॉइस, और आई कैन से प्रॉब्लम ऑफ इकोनॉमिकल यूज ऑफ रिसोर्सेज. Like the basic amenities, right? Example is the current scenario where you can find the certain items are not available, like milk products or chocolates, or they're limited to an extent. So how we will be using those resources in order to make the work. So basically, what are the causes of economic problem? First is the limited scarce means, as we have discussed in our earlier lecture. That's why I have written here present scenario. Second is the unlimited wants, the cravings which we have of chocolates, ice cream, chips, pizzas, and different varieties of items included. Alternative uses I can say is, suppose you're using a Samsung J Plus series and you want something different, or you want an iPhone, but iPhone is not available, so you will be going with some alternative phone which you can use in order to make the work as well as make the status work. Yes or no? Even milk is a scarce product. This I have written here. It can be used to make cheese. It can be used to make ice cream. It can be used to make sweets as well. Till now, I've just given the introduction. Going forward with the most interesting topic, that is central problems of an economy. That is what to produce, how to produce, and for whom to produce. In what to produce, the first and foremost problem of every economy is what goods and services should be produced. Suppose Ramu is a person and he wants to open a business of some goods and services. So first he has to see what goods should be produced, and whether it should be consumer goods or whether he should be producing capital goods. Now consumer goods are the goods like sugar, cloth, wheat, ghee, which are to be produced, whereas capital goods, like he should be needing the machines, tractors, in order to be producing those goods and services. That is what to produce means. And first of all, he also has to make a choice for the production of goods. Like if he wants to make some goods like defense goods, or the goods which he wants for only bread and butter. Basic example I can say is, in what to produce is, first he has to analyze the consumer targets, and second what type of goods he would be preparing for satisfaction of their wants, and third he has to see what type of goods should be prepared and in what manner. That is what to produce. That is the first problem of central problems of an economy. Second is how to produce. Now in how to produce, the second main problem of an economy is how to produce these goods and services or organize those production. It is basically concerned with the choice of technique of production. Now labor intensive technique and capital intensive technique, these are the two techniques of production. Labor intensive technique is where labors are more than the machines, where capital intensive technique is capitals are more than labors. Now when I talk about labor intensive technique, labor is used more than capital. Now, whereas capital is used more than labor, an economy must decide as to which technique is to be used in a given industry in order to have an efficient production. Now, efficient technique of production is that which uses the least amount of resources to provide the same amount of output. Or I can say the production would be undertaken by the minimum cost. Now, next is for whom to produce. Now, for whom to produce has been classified as the richer sections of the society and the poorer sections of the society. So now the problem arises that if the economy only focuses on the poorer sections of the society in order to have an equality and promote equality, there is a hidden cost of doing it. By production of goods for the poor, there will be profits would be very low, and if there is low profit, that means there will be low investments, implying a low GDP growth. Then the economy would remain backward for a longer period of time. Thus, there is a problem of choice where social equality or GDP. Like if there is only production of rich, then where would the poor go? And if there is only for the production of poor, would there be any product for luxurious items for rich? Now, in order to solve these three problems, that is what to produce, how to produce, and for whom to produce, there are certain solutions. Now, different economies solve the central problems differently. Now, we will be studying three different solutions like market economy, centrally planned economy, and mixed economy. Going with the market economy. Now, market economy is a free economy where the producers are free to decide what to do, how, and for whom to produce. They take the decisions accordingly on the basis of the supply and demand forces in the market. And they would choose those products which would give them maximum profits. And they would be incurring those inputs where the cost of production is less. That means the raw materials or the production, they would be minimizing in the cost of production, whereas they would be producing those goods and services which would yield them higher profits. They would be selling to those customers who are already ready to pay those high charges in order for their product. When I go for centrally planned economy, centrally planned economy are the decisions which are taken by the government with a view or perspectives of social welfare. Those goods and services will be produced for betterment of society. Like goods will be produced preferably for those residents who are suffering from hunger, starvation, even when it implies for loss in the production as well. Basic farmers, I can say, when there is loss of production in there, then the government will help them with a view of social welfare. Now, when I talk about mixed economy, India is a mixed economy where it combines the merits and avoids the demerits of market and centrally planned economies. The decisions are taken based on the market forces as well as on the basis of social consideration. I have already given the example in India. The producers are free to produce like steel and clothes in order to maximize their profit. But railways are the monopoly of the market. As we have already learned the basic problems of an economy, what is economic problems and how these problems can be solved, the next and the last topic for today is production possibility curve. Now, production possibility curve is a curve showing any different combinations of any two goods which can be produced with the given resources on the assumption that first assumption is resources should be given, second is resources are efficiently utilized, and third is the technology should remain constant. On the basis, this is a rough diagram of production possibility curve. This curve is known as production possibility curve. Now I have taken two goods, that is rice and clothes. Clothes on x-axis and rice on y-axis. Now as we consume more of clothes, the production for rice reduces and there is a curve which forms as per the consumption of the commodity. It can be consumer and capital goods as well. If you have any doubt, do let me know. Thank you.